Assalamu alaikum, dear students. How are you, students? I hope you all are fine. Now we are coming to our lesson. Today the topic is Battle of Yamama. This topic is from section Rightly Guided Khalifas. In this chapter, students will be able to discuss the events led to the compilation of Quran, and they will be able to demonstrate answers of exam type questions to show the understanding of knowledge. Dear students, can you tell me what were the problems faced by Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq soon after getting the office of Caliphate? Yes, the problems were expedition to Syria, compilation of Quran, refusal to pay zakat, and apostasy war. Musalma. Of all the impostors and false prophets who rose in Arabia after death of Holy Prophet, the most notorious and dangerous was Musalma, who belonged to Banu Harifa tribe of Central Arabia. Musalma visited Medina during the lifetime of Holy Prophet and enjoyed the privilege of his company for some time. On returning from Medina, Musalma, however, laid claim to a divine mission and founded a new creed. He relieved his followers from the obligation of fasting, zakat. He reduced the number of daily prayers. He legalized adultery and drinking. He forbade his followers to cohabit with their wives once they had become mothers. In imitation of Holy Quran, he recited rhythmical sentences and bit of gurgles, which he had himself composed but gave out as having been revealed by Allah. He was endowed with a superb physique and an attractive personality. He was a good speaker and could sway the masses. He exploited these qualities and succeeded in winning over a considerable followers. When asked by the Holy Prophet to abandon his pretensions, Musalma sent a letter demanding the division of Arabian Peninsula into two halves, one part to be earmarked for Muslims and the other to be the exclusive reserve for Musalma and his followers. The Holy Prophet addressed him as Musalma the Liar and said that all land belonged to Allah, and he gave his control to such a person as he willed. The Holy Prophet deputed Nahr al-Rijal, a Muslim convert from the tribe of Banu Hanifa, to go back to his people and propagate Islam. On return to his tribe, Nahr al-Rijal fell a victim to the blandishments of Musalma. He declared falsely that he was the witness to the fact that the Holy Prophet had acknowledged Musalma as a co-sharer in the divine mission that established the credentials of Musalma, and the number of his followers increased considerably. Campaigns against Musalma. With the death of the Holy Prophet, Musalma gained a strength in strength further. The general arguments that prevailed with the people was that Muhammad, peace be upon him, was dead while Musalma was alive. A living prophet was to be preferred to a dead prophet. Many tribes who were hostile to Islam joined his ranks. Abu Bakr originally entrusted the operations against Musalma to Akrama, son of Abu Jahl. Sharabi bin Hasna was to advance with another column to the assistance of Akrama. Abu Bakr issued strict orders that the action against Musalma was to be taken only when the two columns joined together. Akrama was the first to reach Yamama Valley, where Musalma was lodged, without waiting for Sharabi. Akrama launched an attack against Musalma. The Muslims were beaten back with considerable losses. When the news of defeat reached Medina, Abu Bakr felt much distress. He asked Akrama not to return to Medina but to proceed to Light in South Arabia. Some time later, Shurabil arrived in the Yamama Valley with his column. He also opened an attack against Musalma without waiting for help. He was also beaten with considerable loss. Two successive defeats created an embarrassing situation for the Muslims. That raised the morale of followers of Musalma, who proudly declared that the Musalma was indeed a prophet and divine help was on their side. Commission of Khalid bin Walid. It was at this critical juncture that Abu Bakr commissioned Khalid bin Walid to undertake operations against Musalma. Elaborate arrangements were made to reinforce the army of Khalid. Seasoned soldiers were included in the force under his command against his declared policy. Abu Bakr permitted the veterans of Badr to join the forces of Khalid, among others. Those who joined the force included Abdul Rahman, son of Abu Bakr, Abdullah, son of Umar, Abu Dujana, the renowned warrior of Uhud, and Muawiyah, who later founded the Umayyad rule. From Medina, the Muslim army proceeded to Bottaha. Here, contingents from Muslim tribes joined the force. From there, the Muslim army marched south to Yamama Valley under the command of Khalid bin Walid. In the way, the Muslim army came across some men of Banu Hanifa led by Majah bin Murrah. All of them excepted Majah were put to death under the order of Khalid. Majah was kept in custody to serve as a hostage. Khalid collected his cavalry reserves and, carrying out a wide outflanking movement, dashed for the mounds where the camp of Musalma was located. The boldness of the move of Khalid took Banu Hanifa completely by surprise. The bodyguard of Musalma fought, but they couldn't hold ground for long. As Khalid increased his pressure, Musalma lost his nerves and he retreated to a neighboring fortified garden. With the withdrawal of Musalma, his army lost the will to fight and they too found safety in seeking refuge in the garden. A huge wall surrounded the garden and the fugitives closed the gate, thus shutting access to the pursuing Muslims. Bara bin Malik asked his companions to lift him to the top of the garden wall, and from there he jumped into the garden. Some other Muslims did likewise, thus hazarding their lives. This group of Muslims rushed to the gate and opened it. With the opening of the gate, the Muslim army rushed into the garden and let loose a rain of slaughter on Banu Hanifa. The Banu Hanifa fought desperately for sheer survival, but there was a losing battle. All advantages now lay with the Muslims. The men of Banu Hanifa were cut to pieces in large numbers and the garden was virtually drenched with blood. So bloody was the battle of the garden that in the Arab annals it came to be known as the Battle of Garden of Death. Now, student, the past paper question. The past paper question related to this topic was, write an account of Battle of Yamama fought during Caliphate of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq. Dear students, I hope you are able to compose your answer of level 4. Thank you, students, with me. Allah Hafiz.